Государственный музей.
The State Museum of Applied Arts and History of Handicrafts is located in a historic mansion, the so-called Polovtsev's House, which itself is a unique artistic object of Tashkent. The history of this museum is closely connected with the names of famous folk masters from Uzbekistan, as well as with the names of the Russian diplomat, orientalist and a collector Alexander Polovtsev and his secretary Mikhail Andreev. Before we talk about his unique collection, let us go back to 1896. A representative of the Russian noble family, an official on special assignments from the Ministry of Internal Affairs of the Russian Empire, Alexander Polovtsev, arrives in Tashkent from St. Petersburg. A member of the Turkestan Archaeologists Club, he begins to collect embroidery, carpets, and ceramics. As he arrives in Uzbekistan and sees traditional art and architecture, he gives instructions to design his residence in the national style. He entrusts this work to his secretary, Mikhail Andreev, a well-known expert in ethnography and history of the region in Tashkent. In addition, Mikhail Andreev had a good command not only of Uzbek, but also Tajik, Kazakh, and Arabic. This helped him to attract the best masters of that time, from Tashkent and Bukhara, the Fergana Valley, and Khwarezm, to work on the interior and exterior of the Polovtsev's house. Monumental doors decorated with magnificent carvings made of the solid wood of plane trees lead to the main hall, the Mehmonkhana of the mansion. This is the work of the famous Khiva master, Usta Ata Palvanov. They are magnificent museum exhibits. The wood painting works were supervised by Tashkent master Usto Alimjan Kasimjanov. Usto Rauf from Uratube and Usto Hasan from Bukhara worked under his leadership. Decorating the Mehmonkhana, the masters adhered to the traditional techniques, which they used to decorate the interiors of rich houses. Most of the wall surface is divided into exquisite panels and niches. They are decorated with paintings and Ganj carvings by famous masters, Usto Tashpulat Arslankulov, and the Bukhara master who became a classic of art during his lifetime, Usto Shirin Muradov. The lower part of the interior of the Mehmonkhana consists of mosaics made by Rishtan ceramicists. In 1902, the reconstruction and decoration of the building was completed. However, Polovtsev himself did not live in Tashkent for long. In 1906, he was assigned to Bombay and left Central Asia forever. Up until 1910, his relatives continued to live in this house, and then the house was resold more than once. The Museum of Applied Arts and History of Handicrafts is a museum with a complicated history. During World War I, in 1916, Austrian prisoners of war exiled to Tashkent and were housed there. In the 1930s, the building became an orphanage, then a pedagogical college, and a school of factory training. And only in 1937, by a special decree of the government, a museum of handicrafts was opened here. The museum's collections were constantly growing through addition of works of art, artifacts from previous centuries, embroidery, jewelry, carpets, and works by modern masters of decorative and applied art. Today, its collections and expositions contain more than 7,000 exhibits dated from the 3rd century to the present day. These are 20 collections of almost all types of decorative and applied art developed on the territory of Uzbekistan since ancient times. One of the most interesting types of traditional art, filled with a system of symbols and having stable traditions in creating patterns, is embroidery. The museum presents a variety of Suzanese and Paleks, Ruijo and Jainamazes, created by embroideresses from Bukhara, Nurata, Tashkent and Samarkand. Embroidery patterns were given special magical significance. The ornaments could be used to unmistakably find out by which local school and in which city this or that thing was created. Bukharan embroidery was distinguished by the elegance of floral and plant ornaments. This Suzani was created in the 19th century. 19th century Suzanis from Nurata are embroidered with the same elegant pattern in the Basma technique. A Palak from Tashkent with the poetic name of Yigirma Oy, which means 20 moons, on the contrary, is distinguished by the monumentality of its patterns. Colorful, large-scale contrasting patterns are traditional for Samarkand and Jizzakh Suzani made in the early 20th century. Color plays a huge role in the art of Uzbek embroidery. The richness of color combinations is sometimes created by up to 20 different color tones. Silk threads were mainly used for embroidery. In the museum's collection, there are also designers' embroideries. They date back to the middle of the 20th century. Various robes occupy a special place in the textile collection. Among them, the most valuable are women's ceremonial robes. In Tashkent, they were called mursak, in Khwarezm, misak, in Samarkand and Fergana, munisak. Sewn from silk and semi-silk fabrics, adras, they delight with their colors and patterns, demonstrating the boundless imagination of the weavers. Once, silk fabrics were transported by caravans from China, but already, since the 6th century, silkworm cocoons were cultivated in the Fergana Valley. And after a while, Uzbek fabrics began to be exported to Egypt and Greece, Byzantium and Russia. The collection includes robes dated to the second half of the 19th, early 20th centuries. The museum boasts a significant collection of carpets and carpet-like items. The earliest of them are dated to the 19th, early 20th centuries. The largest markets for carpet products were the famous bazaars in Bukhara and Samarkand, Andijan and Khiva. Long pile Uzbek carpets are called julhirs. Short pile carpets are called gilams. As a rule, many carpets have standard compositional patterns. They consist of a central ornament and a border. However, the carpet decor is full of ancient protective symbols. Several new expositions have been created, including in the embroidery, manual embroidery, and machine embroidery halls. carpet hall. Modern QR codes have already been installed so that museum visitors can study the history of an exhibit in more detail by pointing their mobile phone at a certain QR code and find out when this or that exhibit was purchased and manufactured. The museum has an extensive collection of traditional pottery. By the 19th century, three main schools of ceramics had formed on the territory of the Uzbek Khanates, each of which was popular for its famous centers. In the Fergana Valley, it was Rishtan and Gurumsaray. In Bukhara and Samarkand, Gijduvan and Shahrisabz. Of particular interest is the ceramics of the Khwarezm school, which has preserved its unique ancient forms to this day. Badiyas, lagans, and vessels are entirely covered with exquisite islimi and aylama ornaments in noble turquoise tinges with patches of green and blue. Hiva masters Usta Otajanov, Usta Rahimberdi Maychanov carefully cultivated traditional ceramic motifs and forms in their works. The free pictorial manner of applying the pattern by painting with a brush, known as kalami, distinguishes the works of Rishtan masters Usta Ibrahim Kamilov, Usta Sharafeddin Yusupov. Covered with bright blue Ishkar glaze, Rishtan ceramics have been incredibly popular since the 14th century. Masters from those distant times tried to unravel the secrets of Chinese porcelain with blue and white painting. Semi-faience items called chinni began to be produced from local clay. And although by the middle of the 20th century, many secrets of blue ceramics had been lost, the Rishtan masters revived the ancient technologies of making Ishkar glaze. Smoky, bluish-green, and blue colors are also characteristic of ceramics by Gurumsaray masters. Hakim Satimov's Hurmacha was created in the middle of the 20th century. Traditional patterns decorate lagans created by Shahrisabz masters Usta Ahad Muzaffarov and Turdi Ali Rustamov. The patterns Charbagh, quarterfoil, Bodom Gul, almond flower, and Anar, pomegranate, have been embodied in many works of almost all types of decorative and applied art of Uzbekistan. A special place in the museum's collection is occupied by ceramics created in Gijduvan. It is one of the oldest centers of ceramic art, located 40 kilometers from Bukhara. One of the famous masters in the fifth generation was Usta Ubaydullah Narzullayev. A student of Usta Usman Umarov, he created his own school. The works of Gijduvan ceramists are distinguished by a deep range of dark brown tones, which in combination with green, yellow, dark blue shades create picturesque, recognizable compositions of patterns. This is a whole encyclopedia for masters. There is a lot to learn here. For example, Gurumsaray, Rishtan masters, Samarkand, Urgut masters, Umarkul Jumarkulov. This gives a lot to the younger generation. One of the ancient types of applied art of Uzbekistan is embossing. Terutics in the museum is represented by various objects, mainly from the 19th century. These are jugs, aftoba, koza, qoj dysh, dashuj e në kungans. The largest centers for the manufacture of embossed items were Hiva and Bukhara, Tashkent and Samarkand, Kakand and Margilan. The local features of these centers were manifested both in the form and in the ornamental decoration of the products. The decor was applied by different methods: embossing, kandekore, printing, bosma, engraving or notching, carving, which is chisma. In their work, embossers use both plant and geometric ornaments. Sometimes there are also animalistic motifs. Surprisingly, many traditional patterns are based on architectural concepts. For example, rësht, bricks, mihrab, niche in the central part of the mosque, zanjir, chain. Zoomorphic motifs, which are mainly used in handles on the tops of lids, also have specific names. Çeşme bülbül, the eye of nightingale, Koçek Korek, a ram's horn, Kepalek, a butterfly, or Ilon Izi, the trail of a snake. These associative names of cast parts are full of symbolism. They are evidence of the spiritual principle that permeates the centuries-old traditions of folk art. The museum also has works created by masters of the 20th century. The museum's true pride are the works of the hereditary master Mahmud Madaliev and his son Masud Madaliev from Margilan. There is an inextricable link between the past and the present, because even today's masters that come to our museum continue to be inspired by the works of the masters of the 19th century. The most valuable collection of the museum is the collection of jewelry art. Since ancient times, jewelry has been considered to have protective power and various magical properties. However, they have always been evidence of the social status of the owner. In the 19th century, the largest centers of this exquisite craft were Khwarezm, Bukhara, Tashkent, and Karakalpakstan. Each of the jewelry schools was distinguished by its unique decor. Mostly, the works were created from silver, less often from bronze and copper, and only Bukharan jewelers preferred gold. Monumental, richly decorated and filigree Khwarezm jewelry, Koshtumars and Zulfs. Exquisite Tashkent Nazi Gardons were inlaid with precious and semi-precious stones. The most popular were corals, pearls, mother of pearl, and semi-precious lals. Karakalpak jewelry is characterized by conciseness, rigor, and large size. According to legend, this is connected with the way of life of the ancient steppe warriors, Amazons. Karakalpak paired bracelets, bileuzuk, decorated with carnelian, are practically prototypes of armor that protected the hands from the wrist to the middle of the elbow. Many of the exhibits that the museum keeps are genuine masterpieces of Uzbek national art, Throughout its long history, the museum's collection has been constantly enriched with new unique items. In this regard, it is necessary to mention a series of decorative legends created in the 1970s by the people's artist of Uzbekistan, Professor Chingiz Akhmarov. His Seven Beauties are images of Oriental peris, in which the traditions of book miniatures were embodied in detail with great skill and grace. One of the halls of the museum is the former hookah room of the palace. It is decorated with five paintings by Chingiz Akhmarov. They are also created in the style of Oriental miniature and organically fit into the interior of the hookah room. Of course, this is a big school, and I think this museum is very unique. Even the president of Uzbekistan himself pays great attention to the preservation and popularization of the cultural legacy of Uzbekistan. A lot of important ideas have been put forward in this field. Our museum also tries to keep up with the times. And of course, we have our own development strategy, which includes preserving the museum's collections and their transfer to the future generation intact and studying the museum's objects.
Будущему поколению в целостности и сохранности. Это и изучение музейных предметов.
The museum's extensive collection gives a full picture of all kinds of applied arts of Uzbekistan. But what makes this collection special is that the works of the 19th and 20th centuries predominate here. From this point of view, the museum's collection is a real school for the development of creativity in young masters. This is the cultural legacy of Uzbekistan in World Collections Project. I am Shahnoza Ganiyeva. Thank you for your attention.